We're here with North Catholic volleyball coach Amanda Fetter. Coach, thank you for taking the time to talk with us.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Coach, you're going into your fourth season coaching here at North. How have you been able to be so successful in such a short time coaching at North with multiple golds and high finishes at states?
Honestly, it's the talent level that we get. We have been blessed here to have a nice group of girls coming through to us, and the Catholic elementary schools do a great job preparing the girls to be at the high school level. And we actually are kind of at a little bit of advantage because of that, because most girls don't start playing until the seventh grade, and our kids start in third and fourth.
Yeah.
So we get them with a lot more experience, and like I said, we've just been really blessed with the talent level that we've got to have in the gyms.
So obviously you've had players come and go over your time at North. How important is building up depth behind them in order to be able to be a competitive team year to year?
Very. Very. It's in with volleyball, I think it's a lot more about building the winning culture, and you have to have that depth to do that. If you weren't very deep when you are winning, then the people behind them don't know or understand what it, quote unquote, what it takes to win. So it's really important that you have that depth. And we've been, like I said, we've been blessed to have it. I mean, this year we have two really strong classes, and the people that are in between them and above them are really big contributors as well. So it's working out in our favor. So
how do you start developing a winning culture, as you said?
I think it's getting the girls to buy in and commit to working hard and understanding that it's okay to fail as long as you learn from your failures and move on. And we talk about that a lot in practice. We talk a lot about going one play at a time, one game at a time, one ball at a time, in very different forms. And the girls understand that when they make a mistake, we don't really necessarily worry about the mistake in itself. We really want them to make sure that they're learning and growing from that mistake. So it's a very, I think anyways, and maybe my girls feel differently, but I think that we've built a nice positive culture, and allowing the girls that flexibility, I think, is at the root of building a winning program.
Throughout the season, you play teams that are a lot weaker than you overall. How are you able to keep focus for those games and not looking ahead to the important games in the future?
I mean, you'd be really surprised. Those games are really hard to play. So, like, volleyball is really systematic, and it's very much our girls who we actually this year had 14, I'm pretty sure it's 14, it might be 15 girls that are on our roster that had the privilege of playing the USAV Nationals, which is, like, the highest level you can get in volleyball. And when you're playing at that level, it's super systematic. So it's very pass, set, hit on each side. And you're working on getting those three contacts. So when you play teams that are sending over stuff that's different than that, it's quite a challenge. So, and I tell the girls all the time that because we have been successful, it doesn't matter where we go in, we have a target on us. Everybody wants to play their best game and put their best foot forward against us. So although we do tend to handle ourselves very well in section, it's really not easy. It may seem like it from the score, but our girls do a really good job of staying disciplined and making sure that we're staying in system and carrying ourselves the way that we want to.
When you have players, as you said, that are competing at the highest level of that you can possibly can at this age, like in the national tournament, and you have freshmen coming in that haven't had that experience before, how are you able to mix those players together and form that kind of chemistry? Yeah.
You know what? It's really funny because this year we have four or five freshmen that actually play at that level too. So at their age, at their respective age group, like we have some kids who are seniors, like Riley Werda, for instance, who did go and play at the national tournament, and we have a grouping of juniors, but there's honestly some in every class for us that get to play at that level. So it's pretty awesome. Like we're really, like I said, we're really blessed. There's really no other way to explain it than that.
It seems like one of the most important things in a volleyball game is communication. Can you talk to how important that is for your team to be successful?
Very, very, very. Because obviously there's everybody has their certain responsibilities on the court. And if those aren't communicated, a lot of time there's collisions, which causes injuries. And our girls, actually, we do a lot of time. We thankfully, especially this year, we have a really long preseason. So we have 3 weeks to prepare for our first game. And that'll allow the girls to get really, really comfortable with each other. And make sure that they know who's playing what and who's doing what, which takes out a little bit of that necessity for communication. But our girls are really high energy. They talk a lot. They know each other well. And it seems to work really well with that communication aspect.
How important is veteran presence and leadership to you guys during to have a successful season?
Yeah. Very, very, very. That's like what I was talking about earlier with that. understanding what it takes, like understanding what it takes to be committed to winning and be committed to continuing the path that we've been on. And a lot of times we choose not to talk about our past success because we say that, like, you know, every year it's an organic thing. It's different.
It's new. It's new, fresh. Yeah. It's,
yeah. So you have to get used to that. So what happened before doesn't really matter, but it does, you know, like in the same breath. And this year we're returning most of our starters from last year. So, and they're only juniors with the exception of like Riley and Mackenzie Blackwell, but they're, I mean, they've been through it. They've been through it. And Allie Fesco, for instance, she was part of that state championship team.
Yeah.
So she gets it. She gets what it takes. So it'll be a nice ride for them. And this year too, the athletic department does a really good job of scheduling us really hard non-conference games. So we just went to NA over the weekend, and NA is one of the top teams in the state.
Absolutely.
So we just went to NA and got to play them over the weekend. This year we got invited to this tournament that's called the Big Eight Catholic Classic, and it's two of the top teams in the state, and it's all like the top eight Catholic schools in the state of Pennsylvania go.
Wow.
And we got invited. It's invite only. So we're super excited about that and very honored and humbled by the whole thing, obviously. But we going to do that and playing that tough out of conference schedule really gets the girls ready. So that's a blessing for us. And we're thankful that they take the time to do that.
Do you foresee any underclassmen taking a bigger role in the team this year?
I'm not sure. I'm not, like, honestly, this is the first year in a really long time that we walked out of, we had our scrimmage at NA on Saturday, and we walked out and I told the girls, I was like, I still don't even really know what I'm going to do yet with some of these positions and places. And that's not a bad problem.
Yeah. That's a good problem to have. Yeah. That's a good problem to have.
It's,
yeah.
It's just, there's a lot of kids who are just really neck and neck, and it's good. It might be a weekly decision for me, and that's fine. But we do have our freshman classes incredibly strong and gifted, so I wouldn't be surprised if some of them crack into the lineup.
You spoke about this a little bit earlier, but the motivation for the team, because you get them, they're ready to go from the beginning, from the first match of the season to the very end of the season in the postseason. How are you able to get them going at the beginning of the season, be able to build upon that throughout the year as you get farther into the playoffs?
Honestly, it's them. Like, it's, yeah. I owe half of the stuff that people ask me about has nothing to do with me. I simply facilitate, right?
Yeah.
Like, these girls love each other and they love what they do. So playing and getting to put on that uniform and be together, it really genuinely means something to them. And it's a beautiful thing to watch happen because they do it for each other without any hesitation. They really do. And they just get pumped up to play and they're excited about the tradition that they're building. And I don't know, it's like just, it's really great. I feel like this has been amazing. Like, it's just been an amazing experience overall being here at North and the girls that we get and what they want. They have big goals. Like, we have a lot of kids that really, really desire strongly to go on and play in college. So every day is a step towards their goal for them. So that's a big deal. It's a big deal.
So you were saying earlier about how the winning culture and how that builds that kind of esteem to the school and to the program. Do you think that's attributed to getting more younger talent, as you said, with the freshmen,
mm-hmm.
so much younger talent to freshmen and more experienced freshmen? That has to play a part in it, doesn't it?
It does. Yeah, it absolutely does, because those new kids come in every year and push the older kids to be at their best. So it does make a big difference. And last year it was our sophomores. Last year our sophomore class was really strong, and they pushed those older kids to get better and better and better, and they ended up catching them, if not beating them out for positions. Or,
yeah.
And it was great. I mean, they're that group in our freshman class, and like I said, in the sophomores, they're all really good, to be honest with you. But like, they're good. I mean, we're, like I said, blessed. It's like, I'll keep saying it over and over again, because every day I wake up and walk into that gym, it slaps me in the face, like, with how just blessed we are to have the people together that we do. I mean, it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. So
what expectations and goals do you have for the team this year?
I have goals for them to get better every day. And like I said, every year we talk about one of my big things is one day at a time, one game at a time, one play at a time, one ball at a time. So we try not to look forward. We know that people out there are gunning for us. So it's overwhelming to look at the whole thing. Like in the next week or so, we'll start talking about our first games that we're playing. I think we play Quaker Valley first. I'm not really 100% sure because I haven't like put the schedule down in my head yet because it's still like 3 weeks away. But I'm pretty sure it's like Quaker Valley or a section opponent that we play first. And we'll start talking about that at the beginning of that week and getting ready for that. But right now we're just working on getting ourselves comfortable with each other. So that's probably... Did I answer your question? I'm sorry, I don't remember.
Yeah.
I was like, did I good. Even? I don't remember what you said.
That's good. So that's all the questions we have, but what a better backdrop to have for this interview than the chapel right here.
I know,
as you mentioned so many times, blessed.
Yes.
And we are blessed to have you here today. And we wish you the best of luck this season.
Thank you so much, guys. And thank you for having us and doing this for the girls. I know it means a lot to us.
Yeah, this is a great interview. We're looking forward to covering you guys this season.
Please, we would love to have you. We'd love to see you in the gym.